Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen, your beloved Wingman here, and welcome back to the Unleashed Noser. How are you guys doing? I hope you're doing great. I know I am feeling fantastic, off from work today, ready to do some freaking recording together with you. And right now, we have a small little look at what we created over the last couple of episodes. And I'm proud of myself and us, because this looks really good. It's the ice track. If you didn't recognize it, we'll start here. You drive through this, through the cave, go down, around, around, jump over the shark, around, 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 around. It's not completely done yet, but it's going to be once, I hope. I'm pretty sure it will be. I've been doing some more work as well around here. So I've been trying to come up with a name for this place, and I think I have a small idea of a name and also what we can do around this place here to create a little bit more of a better feeling around here instead of just having an ice track in the middle of freaking nowhere. So I want to call this area here Viggo Man's Hawaiian Dream. It's inspired by Danny's Hawaiian Dream in the Skate games, which was a DLC you could download in like the Skate 3 game, which is, it's very old. I still play it a lot. It's one of the games I've almost played as much as Minecraft, but it's like 7 years old. So it's not really up to date, but there's a DLC called Danny Way's Hawaiian Dream, or Danny's Hawaiian Dream, where he kind of has like a really, really nice skate track in Hawaii with some houses and stuff around it. So that's kind of what I want to do. We're going to have the track going around, which is the main attraction here, but we're going to have a few houses, perhaps rent them out so that people can come over and perhaps build their own little house, or rent one of the one I built. And we kind of create a small little, like a community around here, you know, with several small buildings. So I've built this. It's not too impressive. It's a very simple one. But I guess it looks kind of like this Hawaiian, like tropical beach house feeling. Don't you agree? So we'll kind of just walk up here, and it's not much, but you could have like a bunk bed perhaps, and a small little kitchen area. It's just for relaxation, I guess. And it's Minecraft, so you can't really squeeze that much in. But that's kind of what we're going for. I want to have several houses where I marked out with cobblestone. Also up here, I want to have a small marketplace with some restaurants and cafes and stuff like that, where I might want to get people to start their own business here, because I don't know. Maybe this area will be a great business idea. Set up a shop here. People will grab some snack after they're done with a round. You know, I think people can do some great profit here. So yeah, let's drive the track here for once. One more time. I like to do that every episode just to show you guys what I've done. So last episode we made the shark jump, the Jaws jump, and you guys really seem to enjoy it. You guys smacked that like button like nobody's freaking business. And I still suck at this driving thing, but at least I'm trying, I guess. Dude, I can't do this. But Russian Afroman, actually, he's really good at this. So we're going to get him over once, perhaps in a video, and he'll teach us some tips and tricks, I hope. Maybe he has a secret. Because he's really pro at driving here. I think when he... I got him over like on Sunday, I think. Me and him just hang out here. And he drove. Oh, can I do this? Yeah. And I think he only crashed like once. I've already crashed like 10 times. So he's really pro at this. Oh, look at me. Oh, I almost had that turn perfectly. And so this part is a new part. Just the stuff after the shark jump or the Jaws jump is brand new, but it looks really nice. I really like just having this big old turn, and I think I don't want to continue for too long. I think I might want to just end it here, perhaps dig out a little bit, and then we'll have a small track, like a path or something, that you can walk up and start all over again. And then you would have to walk through like the village, I guess, with some houses and stuff. I think in my mind, in my head, this area will turn out pretty darn awesome. And I think it will do in game as well. So let me know what you think. Is this a cool project? Hello words. It's early for me. Is this a cool project? Would you guys like to see more of this? Are you guys stoked, or do you have any other suggestions I might take to in consideration before I start doing stuff? Viggo's sapling? What is this shenanigans? Is it a prank? Is anyone watching? No, okay. Viggo saplings. 10 saplings. I think I take those. And we'll leave a diamond there for a tank. Because I actually asked the people on the server to give me some jungle saplings. Because I'm really out of it. What was that sound? What sound was that? Is that a llama? Hello? Hello, llama! And a donkey! Turbo Jenkins. And you're not named yet. No, that sound really freaked me out a little bit. Last episode, we made some business improvements on our rocket shop, didn't we? We did. We expanded our products into two different rockets. We're now selling flight duration 1 and flight duration 3. And today I want to see how much profit we have made from the flight duration 3 rockets. So are you ready to maybe, I don't know, don't get your hopes too high, but maybe we will blow your mind. We fly 3. Duration 3, 2 diamonds for 64. Oh, holy crap. Okay, so if we... No. There we go. 44 freaking diamonds. 44 freaking blue rocks. Have we made any of these? No, people don't want this as long as we have flight duration 3. That is understandable. And we're going to leave one diamond here. Put the rest in here. We have made so many diamonds from this shop. It's such a good business for us. Wow, I'm so glad it we have set up a shop like that. And people are actually interested. Actually, let's check out our other store here. The Guardian shop. Which is not long ago I restocked on sea lanterns. So maybe people have bought some. Oh yeah. And none of the others. I don't think so. No. I suck at keeping this restocked, but it's just because I have to stay AFK at the Guardian farm, and it's really long way there, so I don't really bother that often, and I don't think people really need the prismarine blocks. They're kind of ugly, but for me, it was just an awesome project, just setting up the farm, setting up all the jazz, you know, setting up the shop and stuff. It was just fun. So I don't really care if the profit isn't that good. I enjoyed it while doing it. So let's leave one diamond here. I think it was Ambi who made this. Let's see. Ambi payment. Oh. Payment. There we go. I think that's how we spell it. So one diamond. Let's put in some crap here. I don't really need spider eye, an egg, some rotten flesh. This looks like art, guys. It's freaking art, man. Yeah. That is beautiful. Are you here all by yourself, alone in the nether? What the crap has actually happened here? What is this? Oh no, is this a ghost? No. Someone has griefed me, I do believe. They shall pay their price. They broke in my nether tunnel. What is up with that? Or did they? I don't understand. Because... I don't know. I don't really know. Why is there a hole here? Anyone, let me know. But we're heading over to the super farm. And a farm we started on building way back, and I think we might want to do some more work there in later stages, because the concept is really good actually, and we have made some really good profit from this area here. So this is a big farm up in the sky above the ocean, so basically everything around here is spawn proof, so all the stuff we want to happen happens up here. So we have a mob drop system where we get tons upon tons of loot. Gunpowder. Been using a lot of gunpowder though. Strings. Tons. And then also like witches and arrows. So much arrows. Bones. You know. We get a lot of everything from this farm. It's super efficient and super good. So what we're going to do right now is to craft up some... some rockets. to restock our shop, because we need to restock it to keep it profitable, I guess. Oh no, we don't have that much. Let's see now. My inventory is a little bit of a mess, I know. Don't you worry, your pretty little selves. One stack of paper equals 3 rockets. So we should be good for a while, I guess, with the sugar cane. Let's put it in here. Oh no, what the crap? That's not good. That is absolutely not good. Well, okay, okay, okay. We're going to just restock as much as we can then. Because I already have this one stacked up with normal rockets. That kind of sucked though. Okay, some more. Let's grab some more gunpowder and we'll craft up a few more and just have them in our inventory. I guess it doesn't matter. You can see some stuff going up here. It's super efficient. Just for a few hours of AFK here, you have basically have all of this stacked up. So that's awesome. I haven't been AFK though for a while, so that's my fault. How many sugarcane did we have left now? Okay, we have enough for making the rest of the rockets. There we go. And then we need to restock our shop so that we can get freaking rich again. That is awesome. I love just making profit in this game. I love how this game allows you to create stores like that. And not just having like a set of mods and stuff. You can actually do it in game like it's in real life. Did that make any sense at all? You know, if people want it, you can sell it and you'll take whatever you want from it and get some profit. So that's pretty awesome. Let's restock some, shall we? Flight duration 2, just make sure that everyone we're putting in here is flight duration 3. That is awesome. Yeah, just like that. That's pretty cool though, like 2 full rows. And we'll put the... No, we have more. Of course we have more. Wait, there is more. Flight duration 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, no, that's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 3, anyone else 3, no, okay, so let's see now, how many is this, it's okay, it's not completely filled up, but I guess it's okay. Let's take a small trip down memory lane, shall we? Walk around in the spawn district. We haven't been here, much lately, checking out all of the stuff, cause not much has changed since the first few months on the server here this season. And stuff is a little bit emotional for me, kind of, because this has been my very best season when it comes to Minecraft. I've had so much fun, I've done so much, and I've improved in so many ways. This is our starter house, and we have some crap in our inventory, and the American flag, which is not crap. Don't you judge me, guys. We have Vigoman's humble cabin, which is my starter house, which is nothing too impressive, but it's a small little cabin. I think it looks really cozy, very simple. We have a small kitchen down here, we have just small storage, and then we have the mine down there. We had a chicken cooker here, and since this is in the spawn chunks, we had an overload of chicken, so we had to shut it down because it kind of lagged the server. Because whenever someone is on the server, the spawn chunks are loaded. So a chicken cooker like that, having that in the spawn district, gives you unlimited of the chicken if there are people on. This is Russian Afroman's house, which looks really awesome. It's kind of like this Victorian Georgian style. Looks really beautiful. We have Russell's house, which is beautiful as well. Russell is a great builder, a great medieval builder. We have checked out his castle before, so we can maybe do that in another episode. The Star Wizard's house, we have T-Man's shop right here, selling some merchandise, I think. Yeah, this is the T-Shop, the T-Man shop. T-Merch, I'm sorry, T-Merch. Oh yeah, it looks beautiful. These are in the wrong position though. Anyway, let's get out. Let's check out the other stuff. We have the lighthouse here. You can see Caleb's space over there in the end. Caleb, I do believe, has quit Minecraft. That's sad, but I guess it's okay. We can't really blame him. This is the FBI. Okay, let's get out of here then. We have this is Will's Not Funny's place. Am I right? I think so. Yeah, Will's Not Fun is house, a modern small little house. Is it done though? I don't think it is on the inside. Hello? Okay, it's not completely done. Or I don't know, I don't know. But it's closed off, so let's not bother going in there. We have, what else do we have? This bull back here, the blue one or the purple one, whatever. Hello? Ah, nothing good. This is our community sheep farm, which we built. Community sheep farm built by Viggo Man. So this was like episode 5, I do believe. Very early on. But look how beautiful that build is. My first time building with like the blue clay. And I love it to bits. It looks really nice. Very like a very low facade. And it just looks really beautiful. We have Dante's temple over there. Looking sexy as always. With a big skeleton. We have... this is Ambi's community cow and sheep farm. For those who like to loot. So basically in my farm we have all the colors. Here he only has a large quantity of white. If that's what you're after, you know. In my farm is for if you need just a little bit of every wool color kinda. We have the small market here. This is kind of new. I don't think I've showed you this. The market where some people have set up some small stores selling stuff. You can see it's just like kind of a bazaar, like a Turkish bazaar. Very simple stuff. We have Dwarf's build. Dwarf is out, I do believe. I don't think he's been on the server for a very long time. So I don't think we'll expect more from that. But hopefully he'll get back. Hopefully he'll get back. We have the Grandfather of Legion up there. Holding the flag. Just looking over the spawn district. Like nobody's freaking business. We have the spawn tree. The spawn tree. This is beautiful. Everyone, every player put their banner up there. And this is kind of like the main tree. So it's an oak tree where we have removed all of the oak and replaced with acacia. Up there is my banner. And we have Russell's banner. We have Star, the blue one there. Elysian Castaic, I think, is this one. Or it's Noble John, maybe. I don't know. Is that a cat? That is a freaking cat. Oh, I love cats. I love cats. For today's episode, I don't think we are going to do much work. Just because I'm running a little bit low on time. I have something to do in just a few minutes, actually. So I just need to... I want to get this video here out for you. And I thought, why not take you through memory lane with me. This is Castle Black. A beautiful building built by Russian Afroman mostly. But I've helped out a little bit. Thor Hammerhand has helped out a little bit, and all the other members of the Watch. I don't think it says who built this, but it's beautiful. It's very grand build. It's a very big build. They built in the start of the season. I can't imagine. Oh, there's a guardian over there. We don't have a guardian. We need to get a guardian. I want a guardian. In the beginning of a season, a build like this. That's freaking hard to do, man. With all of these stone bricks and all the jazz, it's beautiful. In here, yeah, just some stuff. All a lot of stuff here. Up here, we have like the bar or whatever you want to call it. Like this feast hall, I guess. Very nice looking. Oh, there we go. And around here, there's just a lot of stuff going on here. These doors are hating me today. I'm out. I don't want to be here anymore. This lord don't want me here. And let's go down to the final district of the spawn area. Which is the black district. Which is over here. Which is the newest district. Where most of the new players have settled down. In the beginning of their adventures on the Outlast, you know, server. So we have some houses here. This is Jibs. Yeah, we have Noble John's. Ambies. I still don't know who built this. I forget all the time. Is it Noble John? No. No, that's Noble John. Dude, why do I always forget this one? I'm so sorry. It's not that I hate you or anything. But you don't have a name on your place, so it's hard for me to remember. We have Ambi's store for pumpkin pies. Ambi's house for not pumpkin pies. And we have Brick Methods over here. This is Brick Methods' house. And then we have hybrids, I think, both over there where he live, which is very cool. That's kind of all there is to see in the spawn island. Of course, there's many like smaller stuff. We haven't checked out most of the inside. Oh no. I want to take off. I want to see this place from the air before I leave you guys. So hold on. Hold tight until we. Dude, please let me do this. Let me freaking fly. Okay, let's try once again. There we go. Like nobody's business. Spawn Island. Let's fly up a little bit. Spawn Island is beautiful. It's big, but it's so overpopulated. And it looks so freaking nice. Look at this area here. It's beautiful. And it gives me so many memories. And kind of makes me a little bit emotional. What is this? Hello? Crash landed. What is this? The long lost glowing tree. I wonder why it's glowing. Is it? It's a jack-o'-lantern. Awesome. Whee! Well, anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really do hope you enjoyed this small little relaxed video. If so, make sure to hit that like button. And if you haven't done already, make sure to subscribe and all that stuff. And I will see you all guys later in the next episode from the Unleash No Server.